Welcome back. Let's take a look at what's making news overseas now, starting with more on Kensington Palace. Overnight, one of the world's biggest news agencies ruling the palace is no longer a trusted source in the wake of that Photoshop scandal, likening it to North Korea and Iran.
Wow. Europe correspondent Jessica Millwood is live in London. Jess, good morning. Despite this, Prince William keeping calm, carrying on, delivering a speech tonight.
Yeah, stiff upper lip from the Prince of Wales. He has arrived here at the Science Museum in London for tonight's awards ceremony. Not really a smile. We watched him walk in. He gave a very brief wave to the crowds that were standing by the entry, but he is here tonight for the Diana Legacy Award, the 25th anniversary of these awards, and that is given to young people who are doing amazing things in their community and working to make the world a better place. One Australian girl will be receiving this award tonight. The Prince will be making a speech and then he will be handing out those awards. But of course, this is something that William and Harry have always been a big part of. Harry will be participating tonight, but in a very different capacity. He will be virtually addressing the award winners, but only after his brother has left the event. So a clear sign there of where their relationship is at.
Everyone is still obviously preoccupied with what's happening with Kate. Did her husband address that?
Yeah, we'll be waiting and watching very closely to see what William, if anything, he has to say tonight about that. He did make reference to the Princess of Wales earlier today. He has had a busy day of engagements here across London. He opened up a youth charity in Fulham where he played basketball, played some pool and decorated some biscuits. And then he made this reference to Catherine. Take a look.
I'm impressed by her artistry.
No, it's really not that impressive. My wife is the artist one.
It's a bit like watching The Generation.
My children haven't had anyone. My children are more artsy than I am. It's really...
See? She's arty. She was simply doing arts and crafts. Everyone should just calm down.
She's fine. I mean, really. Hey, just that ruling, though, by the Agence France-Presse, the AFP, that the palace is no longer a trusted source. Mm. How is everyone reacting there? How's the British public reacting?
Yeah, I mean, this is yet another sign of how seriously news agencies are taking the fact that this Mother's Day photo was photoshopped and doctored by the Princess of Wales. AFP have said that Kensington Palace is no longer a trusted source. It is reviewing its relationship with them going forward, and that kill notices that were issued by agencies from across the world, well, they're normally reserved for places like North Korea and Iran, and are very, very rare indeed. It's been interesting to see the public's take on all of this. Catherine and Will, obviously deeply loved by the British public. It seems in the American media they're taking the mickey out of it a little bit, while here the sentiment is, okay, enough's enough, back off Kate and give her her privacy. That deadline that Kensington Palace instated of her being back and about in royal duties by Easter, well, that is looming. So we'll wait and see whether William addresses this photo scandal tonight, but it's certainly not going away, causing major headaches for the royal family here.
On and on it goes. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Thanks,
Jess. Thank you. Kensington Palace's credibility is being compared to North Korea as a leading global news agency declares the palace is no longer a trusted source. Europe correspondent Jessica Millwood is live in London. Good morning, Jess. Prince William has just spoken for the first time since the photo shopping controversy.
Good morning, Alex. He has. But if Kensington Palace thought that this Photoshop scandal was all just going to go away, that people would forgive and forget, they were sorely mistaken. It continues to make headlines as Prince William addresses the Diana Legacy Award. It's the 25th anniversary of the award that is given to young people who are making a difference. One Australian is the recipient of that award. The Prince making a short speech before delivering the awards to those recipients. Let's take a look at some of his speech now.
I know that she would have been honoured to see a charity in her name doing such inspirational work. She taught me that everyone has the potential to give something back, that everyone in need deserves a supporting hand in life. That legacy is something that both Catherine and I sought to focus on through our work.
The Prince of Wales referencing his late mother, Princess Diana, and his wife, Catherine, there in that speech. Harry will be involved in a different capacity later this evening. He will be addressing the award recipients virtually, but only after his brother has left, in a sign of just how fractured their relationship is. And AFP, a leading news agency, has declared that Kensington Palace is no longer a trustworthy source in the wake of this Photoshop scandal. It's said that the kill notice that many of the news agencies sent out in the wake of news that it was edited is normally reserved for places like Iran and North Korea. Alex?
It's a mess. Jess, thank you.